and gentlemen, boys and girls, good evening. Welcome to KL City Opera's Student Recital 2.0. We had a student recital earlier this year, and we think that it's appropriate for us to relive that moment for all the students so that they have the opportunity to perform before you, families, and also friends. So on the panel here, we have Alice Ang Ling Ying, who accompanied all of the students. And sitting there is Paige Turner, who is a wonderful singer and also a vocal coach in KLCO Mapleton. Yeah, so together with me, I have Danny Chen, who is the executive producer for KLCO. And we are very delighted that all of you are here to support the singers for today. And we wish that you send them lots of love and applause loudly, you know, each time when they perform. Thank you. Now, for the first performance, it's called the Alto's Lament. It's composed by Zina Goldrich. It is a performance of a song for every alto. Now, alto is actually the lowest female voice. It is about every low female voice who has experienced an unparalleled monotony of some of the most infamous alto lines in choral history. So, usually the soprano, which is like the gao ying, you know, the high voice, they will normally take the melody. But the altos, they are actually the unsung heroes, and normally they will do all the underlying fundamental harmony. Yeah. So presenting the first song, Alto's Lament, presenting you Celine Chiu.
So to her, on Broadway I was there, but you never
So she's studying under Tanner Wong Junmen, but fully online for almost 1.5 years. And her lessons started during MCO time, and she did quite consistently with Junmen, you know, with Tanner. He's not here today, but he sends all his love to his students. Okay, so Erica will sing two songs back to back. One is called Le Violette, and another one is a German song. Hopefully I pronounce this German leader song correctly because I'm not good at German. So Berger Wiege Stanchion. I'm not too sure whether it's correct or not. But the first song is a fresh and light charming aria. It came from Scarlatti's opera entitled Piero e Demetrio in 1694. Wow, I was not born yet. And in that aria, we find a young man named Mario asking Violette if his hopes of finding love with a certain someone are too ambitious. Right, so it's a love song. And in those days, he finds the love with Violette. And then after that, when she did German song, it is called A Good Evening, My Treasure. I will not pronounce the German again, right? but usually it is known as the futile serenade, okay? It means, futile means whatever you do also fail lah. So it is a serenade which will fail all the time, okay? So it's a setting of folk song from the lower region of Germany. So put your hands together. Let's welcome Erica.
Oh,
morning. So let's just put this over here. Now, usually we don't put our mics, our music stand so low, but the next performer is probably taller than me. So he will be performing this theme called the Nubal Symphony, composed by Dora. Okay? So in older literature and recordings, this symphony was, as its first publication, is numbered as Symphony No. 5. And astronaut Neil Armstrong actually took a tape of the recording of the New World Symphony along during the Apollo 11 mission. And during the first moon landing in 1969, you can actually, the moon actually heard this song. So put your hands together for Max Fern on clarinet. Remains unhappy, I feel her sighs more than my own, for I live more in her than in myself. Right, so let's welcome Aileen. was when we first listened to it, so we said, we should go and sing that song, it's very challenging. So, and I'm so glad that we choose to perform it, you know, it will be so amazing. And the song is called The Beauty Is, it's actually from the musical called The Light in the Piazza, and composed by Adam Quetten. Right. The musical is set in 1950s, and it tells the story of Margaret Johnson, a wealthy Southern woman, and Clara, her daughter, who is developmentally disabled due to a childhood accident. The two spend a summer together in Italy, right? This is the story, I got it right there. When Clara falls in love with a young Italian man, Italiano, so Margaret is forced to reconsider not only Clara's future, but her own deep-seated hopes and regrets as well. Thank you. Translated into a live version, the theme of the sound sounds pretty amazing actually. Just a little bit about what you're gonna expect from this particular piece is, I'm just gonna explain what the flavors are. Fragrant licorice, sweet flowers, picturesque snowstorm. You know, like in Japanese anime, you can see a snowstorm, then they start flying, right? The falling grapes. and then the girl descended from Chile, and this is exactly what she dreamt of. So please put your hands together for our little pianist, Aiden Liu.
Thank you.
hashtag KLCO. Right, before we move to the last two songs, okay, let's have a wonderful song which I always hear in KLCO, all the students are singing here. And the teacher is channeling here. So the song is called The Art Is Calling For Me, and it's composed by Victor Herbert. It's a very catchy song. It's from the opera The Enchantress, 1911. It tells about a prince who is enchanted by a commoner, from Yasa, a beautiful actress. So if the prince marry her, he must forfeit all his kingdom, and this will cause a serious comic plotting on the part of spies, conspirators, and also ambitious princesses, right? Just like Korean drama. Right? So the song Art Is Calling For Me is sung in the second act by Princess Stelina. So it is will be performed by Jocelyn Chiu, the sister for Celine Chiu. So please put your hands together.
I just want to
Well, we have a special guest for today's student recital. In the first student recital, we had the Fiamma Opera Studio vocalist to perform as a guest singer. And today we have an in-house a cappella group, and they have recently participated in the MCE International Choral Festival. So they're going to perform before you two songs totally unaccompanied but using voices and harmony. The first song is called When I Hear Her, I Have Wings. Oh, so beautiful, right? Once you listen to her, suddenly you've got wings. Okay. And it's composed by Mark Templeton. It is a sensitive, beautiful love song set to text by Mary Coleridge, and it's a special piece in men's choir. Then after that, they will close today's performance with a song called Gloria, and it's composed by a Filipino by the name of Ely Matthew Maniano. So Gloria is composed by Ely, and his work actually featured in notable choirs and award-winning groups such as the King Singers. King Singers sang the song before, and the Swingles. So it is actually performed in prestigious international choir festival. So please clap loudly for Men Can Sing.
In excelsis, in excelsis, in excelsis.
don't have enough men, so they called a few women and they called themselves women can sing. It was very interesting. But yeah, that's the end of today's recital, and we thank you very much, friends, family, you know, for supporting all the students, and may you all continue to sing. Alright? And you know, why don't we invite them again, you know, to the stage, starting from Celine Chiu. While he's doing that, we would like to also invite one of the teacher, Mabel Soong, on stage, and together with the companies for tonight, Alice Lim.
Yeah.